I am Deacon Roy of Blessed Sacrament Parish in Worcester, Massachusetts. This Sunday's Gospel, the third Sunday of Advent, features John the Baptist. I'll begin with a short movie clip from Franco Zeffirelli's film, Jesus of Nazareth. This section of the movie contains today's gospel. After the clip is finished, I'll comment on it, then I'll finish with another short movie clip from the 1973 movie Godspell.
Rabbi, we have been sent by the Sanhedrin of Jerusalem, amongst whom you have many friends and admirers. They understood why you could not come to the temple. It would have been wrong for you to abandon your mission even for a single day. The reason for the invitation was to ask you one simple question. Who are you?
Yes. I will say who I am not. I am not the Messiah. The Messiah is yet to come.
Then in the name of the living God, who are you?
I am the voice of one crying in the wilderness. Make straight the way of the Lord!
If you are not the Messiah or the prophet Elijah, by whose authority do you baptize?
By the authority of him who shall come after me, whose shoes I am not worthy to unloose. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. His rod is in his hand, and with it he will cleanse the threshing floor.
This John the Baptist, who was clothed in camel hair and ate grasshoppers, doesn't seem like a very comforting leader. You might be hesitant if he invited you to lunch, unless you like grasshopper. He even seems a little bit scary. Yet, the ordinary people, like us, flock to him. Why was that? John didn't parrot the party line. He stayed away from Jerusalem, accusing the religious leadership of the city of being corrupt, shallow, and self-serving. John forcefully announced that the Lord was coming to set things right. By overwhelming power, the coming wrath would evaluate the fruit of their life. Every tree that does not bear good fruit will be cut down and thrown away into the fire. He said his role was to prepare the way of the Lord by baptizing with water, but the coming Messiah would baptize with the Holy Spirit and fire. Then King Herod seized John and put him in the dungeon of the king's fortress. Then Jesus started announcing the reign of God in Galilee. He praised John the Baptist. Amen, I say to you, among those born of woman, there has been none greater than John the Baptist. Yet the least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. How can that be? John the Baptist prepared the way. Jesus showed the way. Rather than, even now, the axe lies at the root of the trees, Jesus said, repent and believe the good news. Jesus' repentance was less change based on fear, but more on refocusing our lives around the Father's love. That was Jesus' way to God. He didn't show up with overwhelming power. He showed up talking about the overwhelming love of his Father. Jesus showed the power of God through his freeing people from evil, his healings, even his raising people from the dead. Jesus' baptizing with the Holy Spirit is an infusion of the life of the Trinity within us. His baptizing by fire is not the burning up of bad guys. It is the ignition of the eternal flame of God's love within our hearts. We are looking forward to Christmas, the coming of God in human flesh. The scriptural themes of the birth of Jesus also points forward to the reality of his earthly mission, while at the same time showing us ways to God. The Christian scriptures say, then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. It's the way of receiving life with wonder versus receiving the way of rejection out of fear. King Herod and the Jerusalem religious authorities took the way of threat and fear at the approach of the Magi and the star, versus Jesus' family receiving them with wonder. The Magi gave the best of what they had in response to God's call. The way of God is to see life as a gift, not as threat. The Christian scriptures say, then the angel said to her, do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. The mother of Jesus is not the only person favored by God. As Jesus taught, all are loved by God, even the wicked. Our way to God is to see ourselves as favored children. We find it easy at times to fearfully think we are being pursued by a punishing God. That is not our God. Jesus constantly emphasized, be not afraid. Our way to God is to trustfully live as who we really are, cherished children of the Father. The Christian scriptures say, by the tender mercy of our God, the dawn from on high will break upon us. The way to God is to live in the tender mercy of God. That way of mercy is also our way of being able to have mercy on others. The Christian scriptures say, Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them in her heart. The way to God is to let the Holy Spirit continually expand our hearts by finding ways of letting God speak to us. These are just some of the ways to God in the Christmas scriptures. John prepared the way. Jesus shows us the way to see life as a gift, lived in God's favor, as mercy received and passed on while the Holy Spirit continually expands our hearts, is the good news of great joy for all of us. This short film clip from the beginning of the 1973 movie Godspell was a contemporary presentation of the effect of John the Baptist's call to prepare the way for the coming of Jesus. It is a joyful portrayal of how the call of God changed them from the inside out. The way of God, the reign of God, is also the power to change us from the inside out.
Baptize you all with the Holy Spirit and with fire!